I hope my screen is visible.
Hi, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And my voice volume is also okay. It's not that too high or too low. It is audible
yes,
to everyone.
Yes, yes, sir. Perfect.
It's perfect, sir.
Okay, okay. And it is my opportunity, frankly speaking, to take participant to be as an faculty for a very good 1 week short term training program organized by your university. And I always ready if time permits to deliver such lectures in any of the university pan India. And I always take it opportunity so that young engineers who will be in the field after 1 year, 2 year or few years, and they can understand what exactly new upcoming things are. And it will be helpful for the industry down the line, because they are the right people who will be on the site and they should know what is happening. We consultants sitting in the office and other managers sitting in the office, they do know something, but site people should also know. So initially these budding engineers should be trained, and that's why it's always my pleasure to give deliver such lectures. I think I am having an 1.5 hour or 1 hour 45 minutes.
So we have 2 hours
and
1 hour and 30 minutes you can take, and rest of the 30 minutes we have a question answer discussion session.
Okay, that's fine. My whole presentation outline is a little bit of introduction, something about maintenance and rehabilitation, health study, corrosion mechanism, then how to do corrosion mitigation and what is the ECAM repair of RCC structure, with lot of case studies, lot of pictures, photos, so that everybody can understand. And it's not like a lot of studies. Basically, the calculations and formulas and theory, it's a lot of practical things. Okay. Brief about vector corrosion technologies. They are pioneer in developing corrosion mitigation solution of RCC structures, and their their products are named for the GalvaShield range of product. So I will talking a lot of about GalvaShield in coming slides. And their office is in Canada, and regional office is in like other US and other part of the world. And these are the whole distributors all around the world. And I'm taking care of India business, and we have two distributors in Ahmedabad and Chennai. And Vector is also involved a lot of in various technical institution. So they are chairing various committees for developing the codes in ACI, in AS and other institution. With this brief introduction, I will go into, like, you people are, all the students are in new construction, and there are our country has developed a lot, and there was a lot of construction since last 10-15 years, and the pace of construction is too high, and there is a lot of structure which also requires repairs and rehabilitation, because our development was since 20-25 years, and we have designed the building for 100 years. Unfortunately, our major repairs start at 10-15 years, and we had seen some structure repairing required 30 years, and some structure required 5 years also. And we had tried to find out what is the reason for this repair and again repair, and how we can delay the repair and how we can do a good repair. What the current practice existing RCC structure is, like repairs, rehabilitation and strengthening of RCC structure, which comes under maintenance and rehabilitation. In the morning, Vijay Dhami sir has explained a lot of things. So I will not go much in detail, but the factor affecting are maybe built in, like design failure or poor workmanship or some other external, maybe because of environmental effect or additional load or change in use or man-made is, this all are natural calamities, earthquake. This has been explained by Vijay sir, so I'm not going much in detail. And type of problem are, if you see, majority of the problem are because of the corrosion. It can be corrosion of reinforcement or corrosion of post-tension tenders. There are deflection and there are leakage. These are the three broadly categorized issues, which is creating a lot of problem, which require maintenance and rehabilitation. And normally when we say repair, people do, earlier they were used to do by connecting. Then there is a concrete replacement using polymer modified mortar or micro concrete, and they are using steel plates for strengthening. Now then second generation come is the chemical repair. Earlier it was only concrete replacement, now they use chemicals and they use strengthening using carbon fiber wrapping and laminates. This also is now a decade or more than a two decade old methodology. So there is requirement, and next generation repair is EKM, electrochemical repair, wherein the sacrificial anodes are used in addition to the chemical repair, and we make a durable repair, the repair which lasts for more than 5 years, 7 years, 10 years, like that. To understand EKM repair, let's see, this is a typical concrete cell, like a concrete schematic diagram, wherein there are two reinforcements which are tied, and they are having a mill scale or passivating layer around the steel in the fresh concrete. Like when there is a fresh concrete, the pH of the concrete will 12, and the steel will having a good protective passivating layer around it. And we can also say normally as a mill scale, and this is Fe304. And when there is a contamination means, which is not good for the concrete. Like if it is a coastal area, then there is an ingress of chloride, which will affect the concrete. Or if it is a city area, then there is a lot of carbonation. And this carbonation, like when the carbon dioxide enters the surface of the concrete, it reacts with the free lime and creates some, there is some chemical formula, and it produces lots of, it makes the concrete stiff, but it reduces the pH also. So pH reduces and steel start corroding. So when there is an ingress of contamination, the passivating layer got reduced, and in presence of oxygen and water, like whenever there is a free oxygen and free water, you will have a condition wherein there is a contamination around the steel, where there is a chloride or carbonation around the steel will act as an anode, and the steel part which is in good condition will act as a cathode, and concrete will become an electrolyte. So like a battery cell, torch cell, we have an anode, cathode and electrolyte, and in presence of oxygen and water, this formula will react like this, and again chloride is free for further damage to the concrete, to the steel basically, and there is a rust formation, Fe203. So this rust, we all know that it is very expansive, and it expands 6 to 8 times its original volume. So it will induce stresses. It will induce stresses on the concrete, and the cover concrete, which is weaker part than the core concrete. So you will find cracks in the cover concrete. This is basic phenomena of corrosion, for the chloride induced corrosion. And what does it occurs? It leads to this. This is the 8 years old cooling tower. This is a breach deck bottom. This is an Ahmedabad city. It's a railway line, RO bridge, road over bridge, pile cap, a column, corrosion, but it is still standing. And this is a bridge in Porbandar, where PT strands got broken at the mid span. We are supposed to repair it, but before we commenced the tender was there, it collapsed. And the pile, 10-year-old bridge structure. And this is 6-year-old multi-story building. You can see the corrosion of reinforcement and spalling and cracking. A new construction. People has not even started staying there, and there are issues. So we don't want this. Till now, if I just stimulate, don't go with the exact picture. What we do is, we do this. Some VIP is going to come travel from this bridge. So it was properly painted, and some engineer has used his engineering techniques. If you see, the angle of repose for the load transfer is perfect. The water is flowing, so to withstand the pressure from the water, there is a more number of stones below, and there is a wooden log above, which also will not affect the steel railing above it. So technically, if you say, it will support, yes. But we don't want this. We want a perfect solution, so that it will stay without this type of temporary supports. So that is where right rehabilitation comes in the picture. Right rehabilitation means there is a structural stability comes in the picture, serviceability, it can be useful, and durability. Durability means it should run, the repair should be functional for a long time. It's not that after every 2 years we want to repair again. So that right rehabilitation is very important. We in India yet to have some codes, but ECI has some codes which says that which sets a minimum requirement for repair, and it encourages evaluation. Because if you don't evaluate rightly, you cannot do the repair rightly. Like in our home appliances or a vehicle, if you don't know what is the fault, then repair will not be proper. So evaluation is quite important, and one should do it very, very rightly. And better evaluation will give you better repair strategy. And whatever scheme you decide, it should be consistent, reliable repair and long-term repair. This has been stressed in ACI code also. They had developed some guidelines. If you Google, you can get these technical guidelines. They also says about electrochemical repair. Even FHWA bridge also, this American bridge preservation guides, it also says on the electrochemical repair. Now, before going for any repair, like what has been stressed on the evaluation, one should also know what to do for the health study. Health study means NDT, not only NDT. It includes various parameters. One should do proper visual inspection, then do various tests, then interpolate and compare where my visual defects are there, what is the test results there, and then decide the strategy. And the parameters which can be evaluated with non-destructive testing or health study is strength. For strength, you need a rebound hammer, you need ultra UPV, you need core for the compressive strength. But this only suffice only if there is a good building and strengthening is required. But when repair and rehabilitation is required, you should have durability performance test also, which includes one should show whether there are voids, permeability, what is the cause of this disruption of concrete, whether it is a carbonation, chloride, sulfate attack, what is the risk of corrosion, what is the chloride content inside, what is the cover thickness, how much water it will penetrate. You see holistically, you do half cell potential test, you do corrosion resistivity, you take corrosion rate of the steel, various tests can be done. This photo shows some of the few of the tests, like the first is the half cell potential, then it shows UPV, then rebound hammer, then carbonation test and core. So these are, I had listed out few of the tests which need to be done. And based on this test and visual inspection and then in-depth study, one should decide what, how to repair and what to repair. Again, I will come with this corrosion cell in the concrete. I'm taking few of minutes for understanding what corrosion in concrete is there. It's so that how to repair it can be easily understood. So if we see that there is an contamination in the concrete and there is a crack. So what we do is we come and if you take the half cell potential, like if you take the NDT, you will find that concrete which is in good condition will have a more positive reading than the concrete which is in the bad condition. And the concrete which is sound will have still further more positive than the concrete which is in the cracks area. So there is a potential difference. This potential difference is the reason why there is an corrosion. Now, when we come and we repair it, we chip off the cover concrete, we clean the rebar, we apply like zinc rich epoxy coating, and then we repair with a chloride-free good quality mortar. All workmanship has been done, curing has been done properly. By doing this right work, what we are doing is, if we test it again, we are bringing this condition. So the old repair and the sound concrete where there was contamination, still there is a potential difference. So there will be a again corrosion around the patch, which is called incipient anode formation or patch repair. Like halo effect. You can see there are two patches for one patch repair, and this road bridge, number of time this deck has been repaired. This is because of halo effect. Now, when you go to the site, whenever you see an old structure, there are various stages of corrosion. I would always advise that you should go and tell to your boss that, yes, we are in stage 2, stage 3, so that we don't wait for the stage 4. Okay, so like once the time of onset of the corrosion, then there will be a first time cracking, then time to first fall, and then time to failure. So these four steps, like some crazy light of thing, Initially, the concrete appeared to be sound with very relatively macroscopic crack and no rust discoloration. That is stage one. This is normally nowhere in the world is being taken care of. Okay. But when it comes to stage two, still in India, we don't take care of this thing. When you see this type of thing, you should go and report it to the immediate authorities that this is going to create problem in the future. This is starting of the cancer of the concrete. So this type of rust and these small cracks is very, very dangerous because it lead to this stage like spalling, major cracks and spalling, and then further major, and then you won't able to use that element. So these four stages, one should be very cautious in the field. Now, what is the corrosion protection system available? Apart from protective coating, which will not allow water or oxygen from the surface, or some corrosion inhibitor, which are also useful, there are three major electrochemical systems for durable rehabilitation. One is impressed current cathodic protection system, galvanic corrosion protection system, and electrochemical treatment. Impressed current cathodic protection system is called ICCP, which is largely used for the pipelines, steel tanks, steel structures, sheep hulk, various places. Not sheep hulk, but the on ground thing. Okay, wherein you need an external current to supply to the anodes, and these anodes will corrode with use of external current. Like you really need to supply a current with a rectifier transformer at one place till you want to protect the structure, and then it will not allow corrosion of reinforcement or the steel. But in concrete, it is very difficult. It is good system, but in concrete, very difficult to design, and technology proven it is not yet that much possible. But galvanic corrosion protection system, it is like sheep hulk. You just tie a different metal anode below the sheep, and which is in the water, sea water. It will not allow sheep to corrode. That's why your sheeps are not corroding from the outside. And there, no external current is required. The anode itself in the water or anode itself in the concrete will give small current, and it will protect reinforcement or steel from corrosion. An electronic treatment, it is like changing the chemistry. Suppose in a building there is more of carbonation, pH has gone down, we can increase the pH without doing anything, or we can extract the chloride from the concrete and we can make it chloride free. That is electrochemical treatment. And now this system cannot be good for everything. Like, you know, whenever there is an issue with the body, we sometimes take pills, we sometimes take injections, and then we go for operations. So depend upon the level of requirement, it can be a corrosion prevention, corrosion control, and cathodic protection or corrosion passivation, wherein different level of protection or different amount of current is required. So what is the type of the system and what is the level of corrosion protection, one need to decide. Now we will talk more about the galvanic corrosion protection system, because it's an innovative and widely used in India also, and it's a very advanced concept. Basically, cathodic protection of atmospherically exposed concrete. This is important. There are various type of anodes and systems available. We will go one by one, and we will have various case studies. Like first is XP. The anodes looks like this, which you can see in the photograph. It has a zinc core inside and a wire which is passing through the center, which is die casted. And this wire is tied to the reinforcement. Like again, when we see that same matrix, when we have done the chloride free patch and we have difference of potential, what we recommend electrochemical repair is that we tie one anode to the rebar at the periphery. Now this anode has a zinc, and if you remember your high school time, the zinc has a potential of -1100. So as zinc being more negative here, it will corrode itself and it will not allow reinforcement from corrosion. So that's where you prevent your steel from corrosion. So additional thing is, in electrochemical repair is you have to install one anode, that's all. Do the same thing, but there's one additional thing. Like as I said, zinc will become anode and the steel will become cathode. So anode corrodes and cathode is further protected. You take a simple example of patch repair. If you see, there is a lot of contamination chloride inside this concrete, and this much part was cracked and spoiled, but other area also there is chloride which might get damaged. So before repairing this with normal concrete or polymer modified mortar, what is required is tie this type of small anodes after cleaning the rebar and tie it properly, then just check with the normal meter the connectivity between the steel and the wire of the anode, and then you just patch it up. This can be done for the beam or column or any of the structure like this. I'll explain you with some case study. Like this is one installation, first installation completed in 1999, and we are monitoring for almost 21 years. And these anodes were first connected to a toggle switch monitoring box, and the current was measured for 20 years. And we found this earlier, it was designed for 15 years, but at 21 years also, it found that it is still functioning because it is over a period of time, it further passivates the steel. So the initiation of next corrosion get delay, and so it required less current. So the life of the anode got increased. Like this is the waves, which shows that what is the current coming. The graph is for till 12 years only. I don't have this data as of now for 20 years, but I can share it, if not in this slide. You can see there is a wave, high current and low current. This is because whenever there is a rainy season, the corrosion rate is more, so it needs more current. So the steel will fetch more current from the anode, and then it will protect. And in dry season, there is less corrosion current, so it requires less current. So that's why these are the rainy seasonal variation, but still it is functioning. This is one of the building in Tuticorin, wherein it is a salt work and lot of damage. You can see on the side how the concrete were damaged, cracks were there. So jacketing has to be required for the strengthening part, but for durability and the next generation repair, you can see right hand side photo anodes has been installed, that's all. And then do jacketing or PMM repair, whatever is required. And this is a before and after photograph. A monitoring box was also installed and people were taking reading. It was finding wonderfully. It has lived its life of more than 12 years, the repair one. Building was 10 year old having damage, but after repair, the repair portion was wonderful for 12 years. This is another case study wherein it's a man-made cause. Like this is one of the bridge wherein a sheep has struck to the pile, and you can see the P20, which is the pile, is missing. So you cannot further dig a new pile at that location. Okay, so what has to be done is you need to create something at P21 and P19, like pier pile 19 and pile 21, and make a support and transfer the load on these two adjoining piles. So what, this is the schematic diagram. Like new stub has to be built on 19 and 21, and then trestle was erected, and then there was a concrete the stub piece, and the load was transferred so that you can it suffice the requirement of missing pile. But for that also, we have to make sure that whatever stub we produce, it will not corrode and it will be there for the lifelong. So in the casing, the holes were drilled, the additional reinforcement were put, and the anodes were installed, and then the shuttering and micro concrete has been poured, and these two white color two stubs were foundation like support system has been erected in pile 19 and 21, and then the trestle was fabricated, and trestle was like 8-inch dia pipe. There was no higher thickness pipe available, so again it was carbon fiber reinforced, strengthened, and then coated, and then this white color final trestle was being shifted to the and placed above the two pedestals in adjoining pile, and then the load has been transferred. And they had monitored the loads, checked the deflection, it is working wonderfully. This is in Simhadri basically. Another case study is this is there was an hurricane called Katrina in US like 3 or 4 years back, and this is 100 year old bridge, and you will be this was the when they assess the health study. This was the condition of reinforcement, and this hold up bars. What you see, the cut bar are not the stirrup. You will be amazed that there was no stirrup in these bridges. There was no shear reinforcement. It was designed in such a way that shear reinforcement was not there. The steel what we see are hold up bar only to hold the main rebar. That's all. But the corrosion was there, so. The steel were cleaned properly. You can see it looks like a new steel, but it is just cleaned by short blasting. And then the anodes were also installed to stop its further corrosion. And then GI shuttering was done. and there are four spouts where the microconcrete was pumped. And finally, as per the new code, design calculation has been done, and U-wrap using carbon fiber has been installed to act as a shear reinforcement. The piles which in the same bridge got damaged, they were also been jacketed using a special PVC modular and with electrochemical repair. I will show you one more example later on in India what this similar type of thing has been done. So like bridge, missing pile, building, everywhere we do normal repair, but additionally is like installation of sacrificial anodes. Now, what I had shown you is the point anode which are used for the damaged portion. When there is a new, like sound concrete, which doesn't show cracks or spalling, but you know, after you had seen the stage two thing and you know there isn't going to corrode. So what to do? In that case, we can drill and insert such type of anodes. Like this is a pre-stress bridge wherein there is a patch repair, but there is a sound concrete wherein also there is a chances of corrosion. So you make a hole and insert the anode and connect them to the rebar and then protect it from corrosion. This is one good example in Dubai where I was there in 2009, wherein first the consultant called me and asked me to access for the leakage. But I see there was a second stage of corrosion marks and water seepage and lot of things. So we had a thorough investigation, leakage assessment, water quality test, half cell, everything was tested. And it was concluded that it's going to corrode a lot. And second level basement was there. There are two story basements. So lower basement was this issue. And it is definitely required to do something for cathodic for corrosion protection so they don't have issues in the future. So we had designed and given them the good system. Like this is the look, like system what we had carried out. This is the sound concrete. So we identify which locations are leaking or prone to corrosion, not entire structure, only targeted protection. Wherever there is a damage, we just attack that portion only. So the green color is the area where you required protection, and red lines are the rebar. Using rebar locator, we had find out where the steel inside and marked on the surface. So by drilling the hole, we did not cut a single reinforcement. Then the anodes looks like this. They are pre-soaked. And suppose we are talking about an anode life of 20 years. Here we are talking about 20 years. So a connecting wire to the anode should also not get oxidized. We have to take care of that small thing also. So we use special button connector, which is green shape in where it has a gel inside. So there is a gel over the connection, so it will not allow any oxidation of the wire and the electric wire and the wire of the anode. Like this way, it has to be stringed. And these are special metal connector to drill the hole and connect it to the steel rebar of the anode. I will explain you in this, like if you see this right hand side corner picture, wherein the big hole, which is at the anode, is in the not drilled in the red area. So no steel is connected. But if you see the green mark below, exactly where the steel is, the steel connector, the lead ball has been inserted and a wire coming out and is connected to the anode. So anode is there inside the concrete. And then there is a connection to the rebar and concrete becomes electrolyte and you had a current throwing. So this will protect further corrosion. We check the continuity everywhere, whether they're connected or not. And then we fill it with the low resistivity mortar so that current can flow. There is no resistance. And then we take the half cell potential reading and we find that it is functioning. And the system is working since 15 years, almost 12 years, not 15. And it's good. Now we had talked about like what we had talked is point anodes wherein for the patch repair and for sound concrete. Now where there are some structures where there is a lot of reinforcement. If there is more reinforcement, you need more current. You need evenly distributed current or you need high amount of current. For that, this is what we need to understand that whenever you put a point anode, it has a limited influence area. The circles, it will protect the reinforcement inside the concrete, which is in the influence area of the anode. Like each anode has a circle and whatever steel is there in the concrete in that influence area will protect. So if there is a more steel, you need very close anode Then we need a different type of anodes, which are called strip anodes or distributed anode, which is a larger distribution area. So you have a uniform current and high amount of current. So it looks like this, and there are other foil type also, which we'll show in next slides. Whenever you are doing an expansion, either bridge or building, what happens? Like there is old concrete, and when you build a new concrete, if there is the pH of concrete has reduced, passivating layer has goes off, and when the two steel are connected, because of the difference of the potential, you will have corrosion at the interjunction of old and new. I'm not talking about the structural connection, I'm talking about the durability connection. You can see this old the retaining wall, the lower portion is the old one and the upper portion is the new concrete, and there is a corrosion exactly. Earlier there was no corrosion, but because of the new construction overhead, you can see there is corrosion of the rebar at the junction. So you need to install an anode at this junction so that this type of corrosion doesn't happen. Like this bridge, they were doing recasting the parapet wall, and so that and they're installing this green type of anode in the lower picture you can see, or this again recasting the new bridge, new parapet wall, but steel connection is from the old below beam also and from the slab also. So this lower there is an anode which is strip anode, which is installed and connected to the rebar inside the concrete, so it will not allow further corrosion of the steel which is inside the existing structure. New one is not going to corrode, but we don't want old also to corrode. This is how you can see a photo which shows that how anode has been like placed. So it will connect it to the old rebar only. Like expansion joint, there are various repair because of the corrosion, water accumulates there. You can install one this type of distributed anode and connect to the rebar, so it will not allow and there will not breakage of joint concrete because of corrosion. Mechanical impact is different thing, but corrosion also it will not allow any cracks or spalling. Like this is one of the bridge in US where 1008 piles were protected and design life of 40 years, so that there will not be any corrosion for 40 years. And they are monitoring for 5 years and found that it's going to function for further 60 years. So this was the condition. They had done some excess and they found that it is going to corrode. There was a lot of chloride inside these columns. What has to be done is this type of anodes are simply tied to the pillars or the columns, and then like one connection drill hole and connected to the steel inside the column, and then do a shuttering and pour concrete, and that's all. So normal encasing concrete jacketing is done, and only anodes were installed earlier. So this will not allow the corrosion in that part for further 30-40 years, because you can always replace the deck, but you cannot replace the substructure. Like this is one of the bridge in Ottawa. If you can Google, we have in India, like when you require to replace the deck of a bridge, it will require at least 2-3 years to construction. If some flyover in the Surat is required to be replaced, then demolish that thing and again erect new one will take at least 2-3 years. You know, like in America and Canada, they change the deck in 24 hours. I repeat, they change the deck in 24 hours. If you see in this photo, right hand side, there is a deck visible. Like there is a steel support and concrete, which you can see that there is a lot of corrosion and steel is exposed. They want to replace this deck. Okay, they can do it. But what about the abutments? They cannot change the abutment. So abutment has also to live for further 30 years, 40 years to the life of the deck, which is going to be replaced. So dam abutment repair also required ECAM repair. Like this is how they do in 24 hours. Like on site, yard side, they make the segments. They pre-build the segments. On the right hand side, you can see there is a yard where the segments are ready. And then with red color, this truck, one day morning on Sunday, they will come and they will just leave the existing span and replace it with the ready-made span and put it over this. And the next day morning, traffic will start. This is how they do it, rapid bridge installation system or accelerated bridge replacement system. You can Google in any of the YouTube, you will find how they do it. This is how the segments has been carried out. Now, what happens is that when you, even if you do strengthening of the like this abutments, the new concrete outside and old concrete which is contaminated because of potential difference, there will be corrosion in the old inside reinforcement. So to protect it from further damage, before doing jacketing, this type of anodes are installed like this way, and then jacketing has been done over it so that there is protection of reinforcement inside the old abutment and the bridge deck is replaced. So they have a good long life of the entire structure. This is one more like Gardner Expressway, wherein you can see the damage inside the for a beam, and there is a lot of similar damage in columns also. This is 3 years back photograph, and they decide to repair it. The authority decide to repair it. They're going to change this is almost a 20 kilometer long main highway flyover, so they cannot stop it for long, for a year or 2 years. So they decide to do in part way, and they are going to replace the deck, but the substructure is going to be repaired like beam and column. So this was the condition, and they chipped off the damaged part. And then design was done. It was like how the anodes are going to be layout was decided, approved with the consultant. And then this is the green are the anodes which are installed before jacketing. And then jacketing has been carried out. You can see one part jacketed completed, other part anodes are installed, and strengthening is being carried out. Then they are going to change the deck. So by ripping this, then 25 years of service life extension was given, and 53,000 m cube of concrete was maintained in the service. So you can, it's a highly environmental friendly system. So it's a sustainability point of view, it is also a good. This is a challenge, but it is possible if we make it a priority. We should know that, yes, we want to protect this. We want to save the structure. This is what I had shown you is the distributed anode system for the bridges and other various where high density of current is required. This is one example for well in Gujarat in Kandla, wherein there is a jetty, and jetty was repaired. It was working for 6-7 years wonderfully. But the piles where there is a liner was corroding, and the piles steel was also corroding. So like the detail that all piles are 1 meter in diameter, and there was a tidal variation of 5.5 meter, one of the highest in India. And the location of, and the, we had decided to go for jackets, special jackets for the entire 5.5 meter of height. What we did is, I will show you the photographs. Like this is the high tide, the first photograph on the top, and right hand side is the, like this is the low tide and right hand side is the high tide. You can see the tidal difference. And this is good for 3 hours in the one time and 3 hours in the night time. So this much time was available for working. So people has erected a scaffolding, and then they remove, cut the liner, and do the concrete exposed. And this whatever damage was there has to be repaired. And you can see on left hand side the white strip. This is the special anode being installed. There is a bulk anode for the higher current to the protection of lower steel, which will be there in the submerged in the water. And then special modular PVC jackets has been installed. And then the annular gap between the pile and jackets, this PVC jacket has been filled by micro concrete, underwater micro concrete. And then pile is completed. And we also did the various, installed the monitoring box to see how it is functioning. What is the current thrown by the anodes? And what is the half cell potential? And we find that they are suffice to the 150 millivolt depolarization criteria as per NACE. It is working wonderfully. It's a 2-year-old system being carried out in Kandla. So this is a sort of pile protection example. Now, if we talk about hybrid anode, like as I told you, we are talking about galvanic system, point anodes in patch repair, point anode in sound concrete, then distributed anodes. Then we are talking about the pile protection. But requirement and development, Vector has developed one product, which is fusion anode, which won the best innovative product in the world in 2017. And it is like impressed current cathodic protection without external current. So you will have a dual phase protection. It has a battery inside with a single wire and a normal sacrificial anode. Both are connected. So once you install in the concrete, it will first throw a lot of current. So it will passivate. It will repel the chloride ions, and then automatically it will convert it into sacrificial. It will not allow further chloride ions to come near to the steel and protect for 30-40 years. Like this figure shows that there is a lot of chloride and steel passivating layer is goes there is active corrosion. When in first stage, where there is a lot of current going on, the hydroxyl ion got built up and chloride ion got repaired. When you had a strong hydroxyl ion layer built over the steel and chlorides are away, then after some, based on design, few weeks or few months, it will automatically convert into phase two with single wire. And then it will not further allow chloride to come near the steel. And so there will not be any reaction and there will not be corrosion. So you can have a 30 years plus life by using this type of special hybrid anodes. This has been installed. I had a wonderful example, like the case is for Rashtrapati Bhavan, and engineers are IIT Madras and myself, and contractor or our distributor based at Ahmedabad. It's an interesting thing, this chajja, where our beloved Prime Minister take oath in this area, and Prime Minister or dignitaries goes walk through this and go inside the President House, and you can see the chajja top, this cantilever portion, things are falling from that. Like, I will show you, this is the case. These chunks are falling. Imagine that somebody is taking an oath and the thing falls from top. Very pathetic condition. And since 3 years, various institutions, all 2-3 IITs and one CBRI were trying with system, and nobody was convinced and conclude what to do. Then it comes to us and we had given them the system. And we told them that let's do a one pilot study for 2 years, 1.5 year, 2 years. And you see that it is functioning properly. Then the whole large project has to be done. And this is the project detail of the pilot study, which we did in 2018 end. And it is still functioning well. And now it is, its full project is going on. This was the issues. Now these chajjas are lime brick concrete with the rebar, no distribution steel. And the spacing was also indifferent. And these petals are also concrete, same material. They are first casted. Then after half an hour, 1 hour, again, the top portion was casted. So this is how the chajja looks like. As I said, there's cantilever reinforced lime concrete shade. There were various repair has been done earlier, but it was failing prematurely, hardly living 2-3 years and then again failing. And because of lime concrete, the low pH, there is active corrosion, and we required to protect the reinforcement from corrosion. So the repair should be a longer life. There should not be a premature failure of the repair system. And we don't want again new construction and breakage and change the shape and look of the Rashtrapati Bhavan to be altered. That was the prime requirement. So we selected two type of different anodes and installed and data monitored for 2 years. Still they are monitoring the data. Like this was the sketch prepared how to install fusion anodes, the hybrid anodes. There was some spacing and connection has to be done. Like first we locate the rebar. Where are the rebar? Because rebar were not connected. So wherever we do, we need to locate all the rebars. Then we check the continuity of the rebar. We connect the rebar with rebar connector with the wire, check the continuity. And then we make chases for the anodes, like small chases to put to bury the anode inside, because nothing has to be seen from the top. Then anode were installed. And then again, we check all the connectivity of the anode to the steel, steel to the steel, everywhere. And we also install one reference electrode so that we can monitor and measure the currents and half cell potential over a period of time. So after this installation was completed, these are further photos. Like this green buttons are the buttons for the durable long with the gel for connection of wire to the another wire. And you can see this black wire is the rebar, one metal ball inside the hole here, and wire coming out, so connecting to the steel. And then steel, this red wire is connecting to the another steel. This way another steel, so all steel are connected externally, and then it is connected to the rebar. All connectivity has been checked, and then finally overlay has been laid so that everything is buried. This is how the photographs are. The person from North America has came to install this thing. This is how the anode looks. It is two-stage current. There is no external current. And it was able to passivate the corroding steel. It was the passivating layer was built stronger, and then it converted into cathodic prevention. It is alkali based, so there are no acid activation, because you want zinc to corrode. Whatever we zinc, we can't simply put a zinc piece in the concrete and it allow, because it will not corrode. To zinc to corrode, either it need pH less than 5 or it need pH more than 13.5. So you should have a mortar around the zinc, which has to be used as an anode, which has a very high pH, because low pH, acidic and other halides will not be good for the concrete. So you should have alkaline material which will activate the zinc to corrode, and only the zinc will able to protect rebar from corrosion. So it was alkali activated. An expert team came. This is the photo of the junction box and electrode where we can take the readings. And we take the native potential and the further what current has been thrown, everything has been measured. And it shows that stage one was working this wonderfully, then it converted to stage two. And whatever requirement was there for the caudal, it was functioning wonderfully. Till 700 days, we had the graphs, and it is the range is this only shaded part, but it's always giving more current and good results. So everybody is happy, and full scale project is going on at present. And this is the photograph where the pilot study was being done, 20 meter high. Now, another is like one of the Arlington Memorial Bridge in Washington. This bridge looks like this. And it's a very, like, it's not only a bridge because it's near to the Capitol and very important structure for American people. So there it was, that bridge was functional since 32. This is the facade of stone, but inside it is a concrete. And it's like connecting to the Lincoln Memorial to Arlington National Ceremony. And it has 8 concrete arch span, 1 bicycle span, which hasn't opened in 50 years. Like this 9 span has never opened. They don't know what is the condition. So in order to maintain that thing, a proper survey has been done and desired being contract has been given. And when they open it first time, they found this was the condition of that important bridge. Lot of corrosion in the rebar. So the deck has been changed, replaced, because they can easily do it. But the substructure was being evaluated, repair and corrosion mitigation system was done, and around $225 million. You can imagine that 14,000 crore rupees, 1,400 crore rupees or whatever is that, that must be going to be used for the repair. What they had done is concrete repair area, a normal sacrificial anode and sound concrete fusion anode has been used. Like this is the place where there was chip spoiled and cracks. So concrete was removed. Steel was coated and repaired, and the sacrificial anode were installed inside that thing. This is schematic diagram how it shows. Like this is the same thing, you can see the anodes are installed at the periphery and the sound concrete area, so that it doesn't corrode for further 25-30 years. The fusion anode has been installed. This is how connection of the fusion anode has been done. This is typical drawing. Like you had a spoiled area wherein normal sacrificial anode being used, sound concrete where there is a contamination. You can have a fusion anode going to be used with the drilling holes. So this is the how it has been used in Memorial Bridge. Now I had shown you a lot of examples, various examples, bridges, then flyovers, then buildings, basements, beams, and other things and various type of anodes. Now question come is, how should I design it? How should I know what anode to be put, where to be put, how much to be put? It's a big question. This type of things are not easily available. We do have in India, but for your understanding, I will say before designing anything, one design criteria has to be understood. There are various parameters in design criteria. Where my structure is located? It is near to the sea, it is in the city, or is in the chemical plant, then the system will vary. So what is the source of contamination? That is location. Then type of structure. Then extent of damage, if at all it is, whether there is a damage or not, whether damage is so high that you cannot repair it and you cannot protect it, or whether why this much could be of the extent that you can understand. Then whatever NDT study you had carried out, you should have a corrosion study report. Then what is the level of contamination? You might be aware that if a concrete has more than 0.6 kg per m cube of chloride, then it is beyond the limit. Okay, you will say it is not safe. The chloride content is very high if it is more than 0.6. But suppose it is 0.8 kg per m cube or it is 2 kg per m cube. Then there is a difference of level of contamination. You have to design for 0.8 separately and 2 kg per m cube separately. So you should know what is the level of contamination. Steel density, very, very important. Basically, corrosion means corrosion of steel. There is no corrosion of concrete. There is nothing to corrode in the concrete. because of chloride or carbonation. Concrete got damaged because of sulfate attack, yes. Acidic, yes, but not because of the chloride and carbonation. Only steel damage got corrode, and steel will further induce stresses in the concrete and then concrete fails. So if steel is not corroded, then it's okay. So what corrode in the steel? The surface area of the steel. So we want to find out that in a particular concrete square meter, suppose in a one column, 3 meter height, 500 by 500 mm. So 2 meter is the periphery and the height. 6 square meter of area of concrete column. What is the steel surface area? I want to protect from corrosion. So steel surface area divided by concrete area will give you the steel density. So based on steel density, if you have a very high steel density, you need very more amount of current to protect it for 20 years. If it is a less steel density, you require less current to protect for 20 years. Less current means less number of anodes, more further spacing. High current means more number of anodes or a larger anodes, and spacing will vary. So your design will depend upon steel density. Then property of concrete. You must be hearing a lot of anodes and cathodes, but concrete is an electrolyte. If the ionic movement doesn't happen inside the concrete, then whole system will fail. So your concrete electrolyte should have the property in the sense of resistivity, electrical resistivity of the concrete. I don't know whether you know or not, the normal electrical resistivity of concrete is around 12 to 15 kilo ohm centimeter. 12 to 15 kilo ohm centimeter. Sometimes it goes up to 20 kilo ohm centimeter also. If it is more resistance than 20, 30, 40 or even than 50 also, then there won't be any ionic movement. So there will be less corrosion. But if the concrete resistivity is very low, like 5 kilo ohm, 7 kilo ohm, then there will be very high movement of ionic. So there will be very high corrosion. So you have to design, you should know what is the property of the concrete. If you add fly ash, then it becomes more resistive. If you don't add fly ash or slag and normal concrete with porosity, with water, a lot of saturation, wet concrete, then it is very, very less resistivity. Because current can, ionic movement can fast easily in a damp concrete. What is the design life? How much years my anode should be there? 20 years, 15 years, 30 years, it's like that. So suppose if I design an anode for 40 years and my structure is not going to there for 40 years, why should I design for 20 years? I should design for 10 years or 15 years, 5 years only. So design life. And then what level of protection? Like you want to protect corrosion from start, you want to protect ongoing corrosion to slow down, or you want entire cathodic protection. And then installation limitation. Whether the area is accessible, whether you can break down that thing and install the anode or not, what is the time permit to do that area? Like in JT, you know, I told you that only 2 or 3 hours were available for working. So whether you will able to do in that time, you should select that type of system. So before designing, there are various criteria. These all criteria has to be understood. Then only one should say that, yes, I'm going to do this way. This is design criteria. Once you design it, based on your NDT and gathering all the factors, and you install the system. But somebody will ask, how it is performing? How can I know? So there are performance criteria. It's like you go for a tuition class and you attend 2 hours a day. But what is my performance criteria? I should get 90% or 95% or 9.8% or my grade should be A, or I am a 9 grade or something like that. That is the performance criteria. So that way there should be performance criteria for anodes also. It can be a corrosion prevention. If you are going for level of protection of corrosion prevention, means corrosion not to start, then current density. It means for 1 square meter of steel area, how much current should be given so that corrosion will not start. In a concrete, suppose column 3 meter by 500 by 500, 6 meter square of area, and there is a steel area of 6 meter square. Okay, so for 6 meter square of steel area inside a concrete of 6 meter square, it means steel density is 1. How much current is required to be thrown so that it will not allow corrosion to start in the column? That is called steel current density. Now, if EN12696 says that if you throw 0.2 to 2 milliampere per meter square, you will prevent corrosion from initiation. So for 6 meters, say I need 1 milliampere current. Then for 6 meter square of steel area, I need 6 milliampere current totally. And if I want to protect for 20 years, then I use Faraday laws and I find out how much total zinc to be corroded, how much current will throw, and we design it. So a lot of complexity is there. But simple is, for corrosion prevention, you should know what is the current density, what is current thrown by the anode. For corrosion control, if there is already ongoing corrosion activity going on, then one should know that what is the current density and potential shift. Potential shift means when you take a half cell potential, when you switch on the system, you will have, say, X potential. And when you off it, instant off, and after 1 hour or 24 hours, what is the potential? And there should be a change in 100 millivolt minimum potential, depolarized potential of 100 millivolt. That is the potential shift criteria. One should be able to monitor it. Once you install the anode, you can connect few of the anodes and monitor it. Like when you put the concrete, you can have a cube test. So cube test says that my concrete is having this much strength. So that is similarly for anode, you have to monitor it. For what is the residual life? When you install an anode, I told you it gives you hydroxyl ions. So the steel become cathode and zinc become anode. So zinc corrode and steel is protected. In this whole system, negative hydroxyl ions are produced and they build up the passivating layer around the steel. So they make it more stronger steel. So once the anode life is over, whole zinc is consumed, then there is a good, better passivating layer. So again, after that, for chloride to come and attack and break down that passivating layer, it will have more time required. So there will be a residual life. After use of anode, there will be a more residual life. And then value engineering money always comes in the picture. So either you want to do a targeted protection for some part of the structure, or global protection means entire structure. Now, you have designed the anode, you know what are the anodes, how it different buildings has been used, different structure can be used, you know NDT, you know design criteria, and then you know what is the performance criteria. So selection of anode, which type of anodes? There are anode available in the market which are 50 rupees, and there are anode available which are 10,000 rupees. It may be different, but if you say one to one, there is a difference of 50 rupees and 1,000 rupees. But if you use anode which doesn't have good zinc quality, it will not corrode. What is the weight of zinc? How much years my anode is going to last? That will depend upon the zinc mass. Then zinc surface area. A small zinc area, zinc piece, which is encapsulated inside the mortar and the whole anode is there. So this, whatever zinc inside is there, what is the surface area? Depend upon the surface area, it will throw the current. Larger the surface area, more current at a time. Smaller the surface area, less current at a time. So mass is for life and current density, current is for zinc surface area. Then wire. You are connecting anode like zinc piece inside a special mortar to the steel reinforcement through a wire. Now zinc will corrode and it will protect reinforcement from corrosion. We understood that. Now this whole current passed through the wire. If this wire is connected to the screwed or welded to the zinc part, and when zinc is consumed, it will reduce its volume. So the connection will be lost and there will be no connection. Then there will be no function of anode. So the wire should be such that it is casted inside the anode through the middle. So till the last gram of zinc is consumed, your connection is always there. That is very important. So integral wire should be considered. Whatever mortar, encapsulation mortar for protection of zinc to corrode, for zinc to corrode, for protection of rebar, it should not have harmful material. Okay. And then activation. How zinc has to be kept active for corrosion for 20 years. If it's not going to corrode for 20 years, that is of no use. So it has to be kept activated. Alkali activation is required. It should be alkaline in nature. It should not have a salts. which is detrimental to the concrete, and past performance. So once, whenever you select the anodes, you should know all these things. Otherwise, so if you use substandard material, then you will kill the technology. Expertise available, whether all these parameter test, how to install, how to design available or not, that has to be considered. So looking to this, I might be a little bit fast today. I took around 1 hour and 10-15 minutes, but still some few slides are there. So action, there is a call of action. Call of action is jang se jang. Hindi ka jang is rust and jang is fight. So we need to fight with the rust. That is most important. Increase awareness of protection of corrosion in RCC. One should be aware. People are quietly aware that you need very good aware for the pipelines. Very good awareness is there for the steel tanks. But there is very less awareness for protection of reinforcement in RCC. So that awareness is required, and that's why I'm always delivering lecture whenever I get the opportunity. Approach to predictive from reactive status. What does this mean? We go and repair when we see that there is a spoil, concrete chunk is fallen and rebar are corroded half. Then we go. That is reactive. But we should predict it, that because of stage 2 of corrosion, there is a stains. So this will fall. So we should do some approach wherein prediction has to be made, and we should protect the structure from corrosion. This technology is available now. We should all should have their know-how should increase. They should understand. And you are a part of this session now. So you had little bit of know-how of this technology. Specification at design stage and codal provision. We don't have codal provision. People are working with BIS. Maybe down the line 3, 4, 5 years, because of our bureaucratic thing, we might have codal provision. And these specifications are not there in the design stage. Even in a new parliament house, they are not kept in the design stage. They contacted us and we went there. They said this is the extra item not in design. So we can't spend this much money for parliament house. We don't have money. So we cannot incorporate at the design stage. So this is the problem. Like, we should have specification at the design stage only. And there should be a codal provision for that. And based on all these things, I would like to say that India is in dire need of effective corrosion protection strategy. Corrosion prevention strategy need to be implemented in new structure also. I had some few slides wherein even you can use it for new structure, wherein you can delay the initiation of corrosion in the new structure. It will be helpful. What I have shown you is all old structure, because this is a very wide concept. You need at least 1 week of program for everything to understand. This is a whole course. You can say a semester course type of thing. But for the new structure also, you can use this thing. And we should prevent it for targeted location. Wherever we find that there are damage in the building after 5-10 years and install anode at that time or repair at that time, instead of that, at same location, assuming that it will corrode, we can install anode at the new construction. So it will not allow that damage. This cathodic protection technology do not add significant cost to the repair. It is not that costly. It's hardly for repair. It's a 5% or 10% or 2% in new construction, and you can have your repair prolonged life for double the life. So it's a complementary to the repair. Repair using CP is economical when considering the life cycle cost. The anode available in the market must be assessed before installation. You should assess it. You should get it tested. You should know what I am using it and why I am using it and whether it is sufficing my requirement or not. And as I told earlier, that use of poor quality anode can lead to a reduced repair life and defaming this promising technology. This is the wonderful technology. I had kept this little bit small because I know there will be a lot of questions, and that's why I kept so that I can chat and discuss along with this. This is one important slide. This is the We Save Structure Not Information. You can Google, you can go to this website, vsavestructure.info. This is an educational website wherein advanced concrete repair and preservation details will be available. There are various videos and various PPTs are available. There is also a free calculator which shows that how much environmental friendly your repair is. Like if you just input two things, that how much volume of concrete you are saving from damage or by having a proper repair, it will give you all the calculation that what is the saving in natural resources, water generation, waste generation is prevented. It will give you all the details. It's a wonderful educational website. You can always visit this vsavestructure.info. And there are various ongoing, every month, there are various lectures coming free of cost, and you will get one certificate which act as an one CPD, 1 hour CPD. So even if you are going for your enhanced, P-engineering or sort of thing, professional engineering, it can be helpful for your CPD hours. So that can be helpful. You can always visit this site. As I said, we do nothing. Anodes work hard every day, extending service life and making structure happy again. Questions?
Thank you, Dhruvesh sir, for your informative and interactive session. Now, participants are requested to ask the question by unmuting yourself. Now, platform is open for you.
US, there are more than 1 lakh bridges which are required to be rehabilitated. They have reached to the level that they require immediate attention. And in most of the cases, the major reason was corrosion of reinforcement. So when we see and we have to learn it from them, why not to, like in case of the pipelines, etc., we provide these cathodic protection system. Why India is not providing such a system at the time of construction itself? I mean, this is we know that particularly such structures, which are very, very important and important from point of view of our future, why this cannot be done?
You rightly said that there are the huge number of bridges to be repaired under US. I would say there are precisely 65,000 number of bridges which been health studies has been done, and within span of 10 years all the bridges require repair. Even Europe also, Netherlands also, almost 70% of the bridge needs repair. In India, there is a study going on, and wherein there are 1,60,000 bridges need to be repaired. In Gujarat, there is a tender where 600 bridge rehabilitation study is being going on. There are 5 consultants who are doing visual inspection for 600 bridges. And you rightly say, there are two things. One is, this technology is 20-year-old, 1999 or 95, 20, 25-year-old. And all these bridges constructed were before that. So it was not possible to do that thing, number one. And the know-how and confidence in the people comes, because what we are talking is 20 years, 30 years of protection. Now, if I say you that you take this pill and you will not get sick for 20 years or 10 years, so you think, hey, murkh bana raha hai, maine khotu bole chha kar diye. Aaj godi khata baje 20 varsh suri chhodu ho rahe bhai. It's not like that. Now people has understood that, yes, if we put this type of pills in the concrete, the anode is the medicine in the concrete, it works, it protects. So confidence has come now since last 5 years. And you will be, it's good, you will be happy to see, to hear that now people are ready to do this thing. It is already been started incorporating in India also for the repair. All the at present going on JT repairs, JNPT or Magdala, your repair jetty is going to repair, then various cement plant jetties, IFCO jetty, what I told, Adani jetties, what they are using this type of system. All the power plants are using this type of system. And at present, there is an AUDA, there is one bridge which is going to be repaired. It is going to use this system. So this is now happening in India also. In new construction, yes, we are forcing this, we are pushing this. You can, it will come, but still we people are talking about saving the cost of painting. If you simply do proper painting coating over the metro bridges, then it will further prevent carbonation effect. That also is not being done due to various reasons. So it will take some time, but I'm happy that after my 10 years of this all lectures and various propagation and increasing the know-how, I'm able to get this specified for at least repair part so that there is a durable repair. But yes, I look forward that it can be used for the new construction also. It can be used. It's a matter of thing. People need to take the decision.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm going to ask the same thing in Surat region, we are knowing that there is a lot of factories involved in the Karodra region. And in that, there is a lot of chances of having that the exposed bridges which are there by the NHAI. They are most likely to have carbonation in a very good number. I think if the testing procedures will be done, we'll find that there is a very harmful carbonation present in there, because already the polluting region, even in the Ankleshwar also, the same thing is there. So whether what kind of treatment as far as carbonation purpose we can go for?
As I told you, if you like for chloride or carbonation, for the bridge or any type of structure, we had used this type of anodes for the various industries in Panoli, Ankleshwar. This anode has been installed where there is more of chloride and more of carbonation effect. It's a matter of thing like where there is a spalling, already cracks, you can use point anodes, and where there are the sound concrete but carbonation, you cannot chip out the carbonated concrete and replace it. So better to drill the hole and install the anodes. It can be done. We are pushing it, but facing a lot of limitation. And I don't know. It's good. I would be happy that everybody is using this. But slowly and steadily, I had not shown you one graph wherein the use of anodes has exponentially increasing. Like in 10 years, it has become 100 times more usage is there. I can say like that. It can be used. Yes, there are various things. Depend upon structure to structure, it can be decided. And it can be used, definitely it can protect it. Not only carbonation in the city area, not only the bridges, the other structures also, government building also. In Ahmedabad, the government, they are reinstating various government buildings, AUDA buildings and corporation buildings wherein this system is going to be used, already specified. You will have tenders within short time wherein the anodes will be there. Whole Gujarat University anodes were being installed. I don't know how much they had used it. That's a separate thing. I should not say like that. But yes, we are putting in specification. Let's see how we are successful.
Another, sir, with the development of this one more phase, that it is under the research at many places, that the surface sacrificial anode, that the anode is fixed onto the surface of the system. What you are saying about that technology?
NCCBM is trying to do the surface anode technology.
Yeah.
Like surface anodes is like zinc mesh or a zinc plate which you installed on the surface. Yes. And is being connected. You see, basically, principle is very simple. Impressed current cathodic protection, wherein you have external current. You can have a sacrificial anodes, wherein no external current. And you have electrochemical treatment. When you are talking about surface sacrificial anode system, then there is no external current, so you need an anode, and you need anode to corrode for a long time by some way so that it can be installed on the surface and it protects the reinforcement. We had that system. Like it's a sort of zinc mesh, small zinc mesh, which has been spread across and with a different activating coating to be applied on the surface as per the design. But it has its own limitation, various things. Its research are going on. But yet it has to be developed in full scale. It is not yet developed. Okay. This is, I'm talking about the new material which has been developed since last 3 years also, and basics was developed for 20 years and tested, proven properly in Indian context also. Surface anodes, I am worried about the activation part for continuation activation for 20 years. Okay. Initially it will activate, but long time continuation. We had installed surface anodes in North America, had been last like before COVID, and we designed it for say 5 years or 7 years or maximum for 10 years, depend upon the contamination condition. We don't design it for more than 10 years, surface anodes.
Okay, sir.
Any other question from the participants? If no question,
things. Either everybody has understood everything and no, or they don't have understood anything and there is no question.
Yes, exactly.
Either too good or too bad.
Okay, so if no question from the participants, then we can conclude the session. So I request Professor Urvesh Barot to conclude the session.
So,
yes, sir.
Okay, this is on screen is my mail ID. If somebody want anything, they can mail my mail ID.
Okay, so participants are requested to, if you are interested to contact Dhruvesh Shah sir, then he has shared his email address. So you can directly contact him if you have any kind of queries.
It is dhruvesh@corrosion.com. DHRUVESH, S for Shah. Urvesh@vector-corrosion.com. Okay.
Okay, Urvesh sir.
I think it is always an encouraging to listen you, sir, because I have attended your previous session also at the IIT. So, same when we planned for to have a new age material, I promptly just search out that whether I am able to contact you or not, and I think most of the participants are going to agree that sir has discussed the initiation part in the very brief manner, and also he has discussed in length the various case studies as well as the use of the galvanized anode technique in detail. So thank you so much, sir, for enlightening us for this wonderful session, and hope that participants who are there as a faculty members, they will also take more interest and give to the students the details about it, so they can be more interested in future relevant to these topics. So thank you one and all. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It is my pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.